All right, let's pray. Hands together. Close your eyes. All right, let's pray. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for blessing us. Thank you for being able to gather here. And we pray, Lord, that you help the children to learn more about the gospel today. So we ask and pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Okay. All right, quick recap of what we learned last week. Who remembers what we learned about last week?
I'm going to give you a hint.
Anyone remember? Do you remember, Simon? Gosh, are you guys paying attention? Maybe you are, but you just forget throughout the week. See how easy it is for us to forget throughout the week? If we don't do what we learn, we forget what we learn. See? Maybe you guys didn't do what you learned last week, and maybe that's why everyone's forgotten. Do you remember? Oil doesn't mix with water. Very good. And what did that represent? Who remembers? Sin? Simon? You can't mix the word of God with what? No? Who remember this? What's it? Yeah, sorry, what was the opposite? Worldliness, very good. Worldliness is the opposite of godliness. See, you remember now, with the light and dark, they're opposite, aren't they? And what's, do you remember the three different ways to be worldly in the Bible? What was there? Do you remember one, Abel? Don't eat too much candy. That's right, the lust of the flesh. That's one way. What's another one? TV. Lust of the eyes. And the last one? Who remembers? Simon?
It's all about me.
All about me? And what did the Bible call that? No? What? Worldliness is all of them? Do you remember? The pride. Pride of life. Okay, lust of the flesh, lust of the eyes, and the pride of life. All right, today, we're on the second last book of the Bible, and today we're going to learn a bit about the gospel, contending for the faith. Contending for the faith. Here's where we get it from, Jude 3. Oh, it's a lot of words. You have to pay attention, okay? You have to pay attention very closely as we read through this. Beloved, beloved, that's you. Beloved is when you care about somebody. You call them beloved. I love you. When I gave all diligence to write unto you. He says, when I took the time to write this letter to you. This letter from Jude. He is the half-brother of Jesus. Did you know that? When I gave all diligence to write unto you of the common salvation. He's writing to them about salvation, how to be saved. Look at this. It was needful for me to write unto you. He said he had to do it. And exhort you, that means encourage you to do something, right? That what? Ye should earnestly contend for the faith, which was once delivered unto the saints. Earnestly contend for the faith. So that's where we get it from. Contend for the faith. Who knows what contend means? Do you know? No? Good try. Who knows what contend means? You want to come into here, Mateo? You come sit in here. Who knows what contend means? All right, here's a hint. What does it mean? To fight. Right. Contend for the faith. Here's what's happening. What is that? A big punch. Oh. So, we're contending for the faith. It's a fight, isn't it? Now, let me ask you. Is a fight easy? Or is a fight hard? What do you think? Hard, isn't it? So that means it's going to take some discipline. It's going to take some work. It's going to take some, maybe some blood and sweat. Because we're not in a physical fight. We're in a spiritual fight. But it still takes effort, doesn't it? Not easy when it's a fight. So we contend for the faith. We don't snooze for the faith, do we? We're fighting. So we need to know, we need to train. Hear what he says here. Jude 22, 23. And if some have compassion, making a difference. See, when you have compassion on people, you tell them about the gospel, you make a difference. Do you know that? What difference do we make when we tell somebody about the gospel and if they believe on the gospel? What's the difference? Who knows? What difference? Let me tell you, the difference is where you go when you die. When you die, oh, if you're not saved, you will end up in a place called hell. It's terrible. But if they believe on Jesus, they can be saved. We make a difference. And they will be in heaven with God. Others save with fear. Oh, sometimes we have to warn people about what's going to happen. Pulling them out of the fire. Which fire? Fires of hell. Hating even the garment spotted by the flesh. Sometimes we need to hate worldliness. Like what we learned about last week. You know, sometimes worldliness, lust of the flesh, lust of the eyes, pride of life. Sometimes that will stop you from preaching the gospel as much as you could and getting more people saved, making a difference and saving them from the fire. Okay? So today I just want to talk a bit about how to preach the gospel. I don't know if you guys have ever thought about it. I'll give you one of these. Give each one of these. You guys have seen our church gospel tract. Can you read that, Noah? We're going to make it easy for Noah. He doesn't have to be able to read. All right? So we need to contend for the faith. If we're going to contend for the faith, don't we need to know how to preach it, right? We need to know how to explain it to people. So I'm going to give you just a brief explanation like we do in the gospel tract so you can know easy how to preach the gospel. Okay? So we start here from black, aren't we? Ah, see it. Lines up with the colors here. So at home later, your homework, you can read through this, all the words, but I'm just going to point out to you the five different colors and what they mean. And that can help you remember how to explain the gospel to somebody else. So the first one is black. We have all sinned by breaking God's laws. We're all sinners, aren't we? We've done the wrong thing. So this is why it's black. Black represents the sin in our life, our disobedience to God. Number one. How many more we got left? Four more. Right. Number two. God is holy and must punish sin. There's a punishment for our sin, isn't it? So why is this orange? What's the punishment? You know, Simon? We go to hell, don't we? Hello. Come sit down, guys. Orange represents the fire. The fires of hell. So remember, black, sin, orange. Pay attention, guys. I'm going to get one for you, boys. There you go. You take this home. You can read it later. We're just learning quickly how to explain the gospel. Orange. God is holy, must punish sin. Orange represents hell. Okay, now we go on to the red one. Jesus Christ took the punishment for us. So what do you think the red represents? What do you think, Sarah? The blood of Jesus. Right, so we've got our sin, we've got the hell, blood of Jesus. Now we go on to the back. Point number four, how many we got left? Hands up. How many you got left, Ryan? Two more. Blue is believe. Sometimes I remember it like that. Believe, blue. Believe and receive. Can you see there at the top? Believe and receive the gift of eternal life. So we receive the gift of eternal life by believing. So what does the blue represent? What do you guys think? What do you think, Jordan? What do you think blue represents? Believe, yeah. Why do we have blue there? No? Why do we have blue there? What do you guys think? Simon? Yes, it's to remind us that once we believe on Jesus Christ, like water, we are washed of our sins, aren't we? Jesus pays for our sins. Then the last one, we have number five. Everyone look down. Come on, try and pay attention, guys. It's okay, Ari, your dad's coming. Number five, everyone look down at the green one. Everyone look down at the green one. Atticus, look down at the green one. Noah, look down at the green one. Try not to be distracted. Green one is number five. Look at what it says. Once you are saved, you are always saved. So why is that one green? Who knows why that one's green? Sarah. Huh? Heaven. Yeah, heaven. We have eternal life. So when you think about the trees and the grass, think about life, don't you? Things that are alive. That's why we have it green. So you can remember. Now, who remembers? We just go over them. What did the black represent? Simon.
Sin.
Sin. What does orange represent? Do you remember? Yeah, so what did the orange represent? That's the point. What does the orange represent? So Ryan, you try. Hell, that's right. Fires of hell. Red, what does the red represent? Abel? Blood of Jesus Christ, right? Jesus Christ took the punishment for us. Blue? The water washes us. All right, the spiritual water, the Holy Spirit. And green? Sarah? Heaven, but what about heaven? Sean? Eternal life, isn't it? So life, if you think about life, eternal life in heaven is green. Okay, so we remember those 5 points. The colors can help you. Black, and then you have a more in-depth explanation here. You guys can read through it later. So remember those 5 points, and you want to give some, obviously when you preach the gospel, you want to give somebody a verse. So there's one we want to remember, just for you kids. Sometimes when we preach to adults, we can give a lot more of God's word. But for kids, if you just remember one for now, it'll get you started. Who knows this one? John 3:16. It's inside here as well, in the red panel. If you look at the red one at the very bottom, you see at the bottom there, John 3:16. Let's read it all together. You ready? John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So you can explain even the 5 points from here. So let's just break this down quickly. For God so loved the world. What does that mean? God loved us so much. Didn't he? Loved the world. He loved everyone so much that, what did he do? He gave his only begotten Son. That was Jesus. That's the red one. And whosoever believeth in him, or which one was that one? It's the blue one, isn't it? Should not perish. Orange. Right, the hell. Why do we perish? Because of our sin. Black one. But have everlasting life. Do you see how you can explain these 5 points just from one Bible verse? Right? So if you memorize this Bible verse, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Who thinks they're able to memorize it now?
I know.
You know it already. All right, close your eyes and you say it for everyone. Wow, very good, very good. Well done, Mateo. Who else knows it? You reckon you can memorize it? All right, close your eyes. Give it a shot. Close your eyes. There you go. It's gone. You were going to sneak a peek, eh? See, I'm smarter than that. Simon, you know it? I'll give you one more look. You know? Okay, go. Very good. You want to have one more go, Jordan? Have a look one more time. Give you 10 seconds. See if you can memorize it. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. All right, go. Very good. You're getting there. A few mistakes, but hey, now you've got the pamphlet there. You can go home. You can read it again, right? Memorize it. Maybe we'll try again next week. Maybe we'll have a prize for people that memorize it. Okay. All right. So, this is what Jesus Christ did for us. So, hey, you guys need to make sure. We not only need to make sure we can know how to explain. Hey, don't talk, guys. We don't only need to make sure we know how to explain it. We need to make sure we believe it ourselves. Right? We need to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Okay, so we know we're sinners. Hell, the blood of Jesus washes us, and we have everlasting life. Okay, easy way to remember it. That's why we have them colored like this in our gospel pamphlet. Okay, hope you learned something today. Stand up. We're going to do some games.